Okay, we are looking at now question number 27 from S.C. Verma, chapter number 17, that is light waves. This is there in volume 1. Okay, so let's look at the question. Two coherent point sources S1 and S2 vibrating in phase emit light of wavelength lambda. Okay, let's draw the diagram. So this is, let's say, S1, and this is, let's say, S2. Okay. The separation between the sources is 2 lambda. So we have 2 lambda over here. Okay. Now, consider a line through S2 and perpendicular to the line S1, S2. What is the smallest distance from S2 where a minimum of intensity occurs? Okay. So from S2, we are drawing a line like this. And this line is perpendicular to S1, S2. Okay. So this angle is 90 degrees, right? Now the question says that as you move along this new line, okay, as you move along this line, where is the minimum distance from S2 to obtain a destructive interference? They are asking minimum of intensity occurs, right? Minimum of intensity means a destructive interference. So let's say we have the point P. So we want destructive interference at point P. Okay, such that if you take this distance to be equal to x, then x will be minimum. We have to find the minimum value of this x so that we have a destructive interference at point P. All right. So for destructive interference, what do we want? The wave coming from S1 when it reaches P. So this sound wave will come from, sorry, light wave will come from S1 and will reach the point P. Okay. So the path traveled by this wave will be how much? S1p. Similarly, the second wave will start from S2 and will reach the point P. So the path traveled by the second wave will be what? S2p. So the path difference S1p minus S2p should be what? Odd multiple of lambda by 2. 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. Okay. Now let's draw the diagram again. So here we have S1. Here we have S2. Okay, now let's take a wave coming from S1 and directly reaching S2. Okay, so what we could write? Interference at S2. Okay, now one wave is coming from S1 and reaching S2, and the second wave will start at S2 itself, correct? So the path covered by S2 will be 0, but the path covered by the wave from S1 will be S1, S2, and that is equal to how much? 2 lambda. So the path difference at S2 will be how much? We could say 2 lambda, correct? Now let's take one more situation, one more scenario. So again we draw the two sources, S1, S2, the waves coming from S1 and S2. Now let's see, the waves are going all the way up to infinity like this. Okay, so both the waves are going up to infinity parallel to each other. They will meet at infinity. Okay, they meet at infinity, right? So when these two rays reach infinity, they will be covering the same path, this equal path length. So the path difference will be equal to 0 at infinity. Now understand the situation. So when you start at S2, we have path difference 2 lambda. But as you start going away from S2 along this line, the path difference is decreasing until it becomes 0 at infinity. Got it? You have to move along this line. Okay. So at S2, path difference is 2 lambda. At infinity, path difference is 0. So as you move along this line, path difference is decreasing from 2 lambda to 0. Okay. So again, we have the point P. So we can conclude something here that the path difference at P, the path difference at P, that is what? So S1P minus S2P. Okay. So we have S1P minus S2P. Correct. This will be greater than 0 because at infinity path difference is becoming 0, right? But this will be less than 2 lambda. correct? Because at S2 path difference is 2 lambda. So as you're going from S2 to infinity, path difference is decreasing from 2 lambda to 0. So the path difference at P will be more than 0 but less than 2 lambda. Clear? Now, so that's what we have to solve. Okay. So we have to find the minimum value of S2P. We have to find the minimum value of X. This X we have to find out. Okay. And S1, S2 is equal to how much? This is equal to 2 lambda, correct? So first of all, let's find out S1P. So S1P will be how much? Apply Pythagoras theorem. This is a right angle triangle. Okay, this is a right angle triangle. So square of 2 lambda plus square of X will be equal to square of hypotenuse. So the hypotenuse will be equal to under root 4 lambda square plus X square. Okay, then now let's come back over here. So hypotenuse is what? Under root 4 lambda square plus X square, correct? Now we want odd multiple of S1P minus S2P. Okay, so minimum value of X will be when? Okay, first of all, what are the possible values between 0 and 2 lambda? So this can be equal to, you could say 0.5 lambda. Then we have 1.5 lambda. These are only the odd multiples possible. Okay, so this is what? This is what? Lambda by 2. This is what? 3 times lambda by 2. Lambda by 2 and 3 times lambda by 2. Correct. What did I mention here? We want odd multiples of the S1P minus S2P. So as you're going away from S2, at S2 path difference is 2 lambda, then path difference will decrease to 3 lambda by 2. Then as you keep going further, so here we have 1.5 lambda by 2, then somewhere we will have path difference lambda, then somewhere we will have path difference lambda by 2. So path difference will keep on decreasing as you go away. So the minimum X where we get destructive interference will be when we have path difference 1.5 lambda by 2. Okay, so that's what we have to solve now. Okay, so we found that S1P minus S2P will be equal to 3 lambda by 2. Okay, now just we have to put the values and solve this. So S1P is how much? S1P is under root 4 lambda square. This is 4 lambda, okay. So 4 lambda square plus X square, that is S1P. Minus S2P, S2P will be X, okay. This is equal to 3 lambda by 2. So we just solve this equation, we find our answer, okay. So root of 4 lambda square plus X square equal to 3 lambda by 2 plus X. Then squaring on both the sides, so here we get 4 lambda square plus X square equal to, here we have to square a plus b whole square, so a square plus b square plus 2ab, so 9 lambda square by 4 plus X square plus 3 lambda X. Okay, now so X square will get cancelled out, correct? Then 4 lambda square minus 9 lambda square by 4 equal to 3 lambda X. Okay, so 4 lambda square minus 9 lambda square by 4, this will give you 4 into 4 16 minus 9 7 lambda square by 4 equal to 3 lambda X. And then finally you get X equal to 7 lambda by 3 into 4 12. Okay, so this is the minimum value of X. All right, so this is your final answer.